Hello and welcome to the NVE training video on what every truck operator must know. Today, we will go over the basic fundamentals on the vacuum system, the operating procedures on the Challenger Series vacuum pump, and go over a truck operator's daily checklist to aid in the operation of the vacuum truck. At the start of the shift, the driver should always check the oil level in the oil reservoir. The oil level should be filled to the top of the oil reservoir with the proper lubricant. Use only new oil. The best type of oil to use is an ISO 68 turbine oil. Inspect the drive coupler and check for any damage or severe wear. Turn the drive coupler by hand to make sure the vacuum pump and the drive system turns freely. Inspect the vacuum pump oil system for leaks. Drain the oil catch muffler and dispose of the waste material properly. Drain the secondary shutoff and dispose of waste material properly. Put the vacuum pump handle in the neutral position. This will ensure that there is no vacuum or pressure in the tank and will allow the pump to start or turn easily when the PTO is engaged. Steps to begin the initial start of the vacuum pump. Engage the clutch, put the transmission in neutral, engage the PTO, slowly disengage the clutch. Do not disengage the clutch abruptly or dump the clutch because this will damage the drive coupler. The vacuum pump is now turning and must run at the proper RPM. The truck tachometer or the dash of the truck should be marked showing the proper RPM to run the truck engine to operate the vacuum pump at the correct RPM. The standard operating speed for the 607 Pro Challenger vacuum pump is 1,000 to 1,250 RPM. The standard operating speed for the 866 Challenger vacuum pump is 850 to 950 RPM. The driver should never operate the vacuum pump without knowing the proper RPM to run the truck engine. Turn the vacuum handle to vacuum or pressure depending on whether you are loading or unloading. Never feather the four-way valve while pumping in between vacuum and pressure. Always open a valve on the tank before running the vacuum pump in the pressure mode. Things to monitor during the vacuum pump operation. Monitor the exhaust temperature on the vacuum pump intermittently. Do not exceed 375 degrees. Monitor the vacuum and pressure gauges to make sure that the vacuum pump does not exceed 22 inches of vacuum during loading and 15 psi when offloading. Pay attention for different or unusual sounds coming from your vacuum pump. Listen for changes that can be caused by the shutoff ball prematurely seating up against the rubber seat, shutting off the flow of air to the vacuum pump. If this happens, you will need to put the vacuum pump handle in the neutral position and bleed the vacuum off the vacuum tank. Monitor the sight tube or float level indicator to determine the load level in the vacuum tank. Once the vacuum tank is full or empty, turn the valve handle on the vacuum pump to neutral. This is the center position on the four-way valve. Get in the truck and disengage the PTO. At the end of your shift, you should always drain the oil catch muffler, drain the secondary shutoff, refill the vacuum pump oil reservoir with the recommended turbine oil. Do not reuse contaminated oil from the oil catch muffler. Always be aware of any changes in the sound of your vacuum pump, change in oil consumption, any abnormal happenings out of character, or the vacuum pump or vacuum system is not working properly. If you notice any changes in your vacuum pump or system performance, notify maintenance or refer to the maintenance guides. And now a few important operating tips. Always do a safety check of your vacuum truck and vacuum tank. Get familiar with the vacuum tank and the vacuum system you were operating. Always softly engage the PTO and slowly release your foot off the clutch to engage the vacuum pump. Always know the proper RPM to run your truck engine while operating the vacuum pump. Always relieve the vacuum or pressure from the vacuum tank after loading or unloading. Always ensure the vacuum relief valve and pressure relief valves are installed in the vacuum system. And always know the vacuum relief and pressure relief settings are on the tank you are operating, and always know the proper setting. Clean the pump inlet filter daily. Never run the vacuum pump without oil. Do not engage the PTO at a high RPM. Only engage at idle. Never engage the PTO and quickly remove your foot from the clutch. Never rev up the truck RPM during the loading or unloading to increase the speed of your vacuum pump. Never open any manway, secondary shutoff, primary shutoff, or quick coupling with pressure on the vacuum tank. Do not open the ball valve on the scrubber with the vacuum on the tank. This will allow foreign material to enter the pump. When draining the secondary shutoff, if nothing comes out when the ball valve is opened, never assume the secondary shutoff is empty. Always check for blockage. Never tamper or make the vacuum or pressure relief valves not function properly. Vacuum and pressure reliefs are adjustable and are not preset. Do not exceed the vacuum pump and vacuum tank manufacturer's recommendations. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video on what every vacuum truck operator must know when operating a vacuum truck. We hope this gives you a better understanding of the basics of the vacuum system, the operating procedures on the Challenger Series vacuum pumps, and what you should be doing on a daily basis when you're loading or offloading your vacuum tank. Always be confident that when you purchase an NVE product, you now have partnered with the industry leader in engineering, manufacturing, and customer service. Qualities that are unmatched by the competition. As always, the Challenger pumps are designed, built, and supported in the United States of America.